If you enjoy the content on this channel, please like and subscribe. Farinelli is a 1994 internationally co-produced biographical drama film directed by Gérard Corbiau and starring Stefano Dionisi, Enrico Lo Verso, Elsa Zylberstein, and Jeroen Krabbé. It centers on the life and career of the 18th century Italian opera singer Carlo Broschi, known as Farinelli, considered the greatest castrato singer of all time, as well as his relationship with his brother, the composer Riccardo Broschi. Just a little background on the real Farinelli. Farinelli was born on the 24th of January 1705 and died on the 16th of September 1782. It was the stage name for Carlo Maria Michelangelo Nicola Broschi, a celebrated Italian castrato singer of the 18th century and one of the greatest singers of the history of opera. Farinelli has been described as having a soprano vocal range and having sung the highest customary note at the time, known as a C6. Now a bit of background about the castratos. A castrato was a male singer who underwent castration before puberty in order to retain his singing voice equivalent to that of a soprano, a mezzo-soprano, or a contralto. The voice can occur in one who, due to endocrinological condition, never reaches sexual maturity. Castration before puberty, or in the early stages, prevents the larynx from being transformed by normal physiological events of puberty. As a result, the vocal range of prepubescent, shared by both sexes, is largely retained, and the voice develops into adulthood in a unique way. Prepubescent castration for this purpose diminished greatly in the late 18th century. Methods of castration used to terminate the onset of puberty varied. Methods involved using opium to medically induce a coma, then submerging the boy into ice or milk bath, with the procedure of either severing the vas deferens, similar to a vasectomy, twisting the testicles until they atrophied, or a complete removal via surgical cutting was performed. However, the complete removal of the testicles was not a popular used technique. The procedure was usually done to boys around the age of 8 to 10. Recovery time from the procedure took around 2 weeks. The means by which future singers were prepared could lead to premature death. To prevent the child from experiencing intense pain of castration, many were inadvertently administered lethal doses of opium or some sort of a narcotic, or were killed by overlong compression on the carotid artery in the neck, intended to render them unconscious during the castration procedure. Geographic locations of which these procedures took place is not known specifically. During the 18th century itself, the music historian Charles Burney was sent from pillar to post in search of places where the operation could be carried out. As the castrato's body grew, his lack of testosterone meant that his bone joints did not harden in a normal manner. Thus, the limbs of the castrati often grew unusually long, as did their ribs. This, combined with intensive training, gave them unrivaled lung power and breath capacity, operating through small child-sized-like vocals. Their voices were extraordinarily flexible and quite different from the equivalent of adult female voice. Their vocal range was higher than that of an uncastrated adult male. Listening to the only surviving recordings of the castrato, one can hear the lower part of the voice sounds like super high tenor with a more falsetto-like upper register above that. Castrati were rarely referred to as such. In the 18th century, the euphemism musico was much more generally used, although it usually carried derogatory implications. Another synonym was univerato, literally meaning emasculated. A eunuch is more general term since, historically meaning eunuchs were castrated after puberty, and thus the castration had no impact on their voices. The first documents mentioning castrati are Italian church records from the 1550s. In the Baroque and classical music eras, these singers were highly appreciated by opera composers as well. Mozart's Exultant Jubilat, Alighieri's Miseri, and other pieces from the period now sung by sopranos and countertenors were written for castrati. Some of the alto parts of Handel's Messiah were first sung by the castrato. The last true castrato was Alessandro Morosenti, born in 1858 and died in 1922, who served in the Sistine Chapel Choir. It was not until the late 19th century that the Roman Catholic Church officially condemned the production of castrati. In modern times, Mexican Javier Medina is the only professional opera singer who can perform as a castrato, since he had involuntary chemical castration as a result of cancer treatment that he'd had before he reached puberty. Now, although Dionisi provided the speaking voice, originally in French, Farinelli's singing voice was given to him by Ewa Malas Godlewenska and the American countertenor Derek Lee Rangan, who recorded separately and then digitally merged to recreate the sound of the castrato. Its musical director was French harpsichordist and conductor Christophe Rousseau. The musical recording was made at the concert hall, the Arsenal in Metz, with the orchestra Les Talents Lyriques. Relatively little detail is known about Farinelli's life, and the film makes inventive use of what is known, including elements of which there's no historical basis. Among the historically documented elements of the film are the rivalry between Handel and Porpora, the account of Farinelli competing with the trumpeter for holding a note, and his skill as a harpsichordist. Although loosely based on known events, the film takes dramatic license with many specific details on the music and the facts of Farinelli's life. The film is largely concerned with the speculative psychological account of Farinelli's experience. The central tension between Farinelli and his brother portrayed in the film is that Riccardo had him castrated, which is doubtful. Likewise, a meeting between Farinelli and Handel in Naples, in which Farinelli spits on the composer, is also dubious. Riccardo Broschi had less importance in Farinelli's career than is depicted in the film, and neither brother was dependent on each other, as the film suggests. The idea that Farinelli raised his brother's child is simply fanciful, as is the notion that after hearing Farinelli sing in his operatic work, Handel was no longer able to compose. Farinelli was released in 1994 and won the Golden Globe for Best Foreign Language Film in 1995. It was also nominated for an Academy Award in the same category. Now, I came across this little-known film the other day after reading an article about the castrato singers. Being a classical music fan, I was absolutely fascinated, also shocked and appalled that people could have done this to these young boys, but in the same breath, fascinated to hear and see exactly how Farinelli's life played out, even in this sort of fictional take on it. Look, little is known really about the true Farinelli and what he went through, and so yes, the film really does play loose with the historical facts, as it were. But I didn't really mind that so much. I was more fascinated by the music, by the fantastic cinematography and the wonderful acting performance here, particularly from the two brothers, Stefano Dionisi playing Carlo Maria Broschi or Farinelli, and Enrico Lo Verso playing Riccardo Broschi. The film is beautiful, it's visually stunning, and the cinematography just captures the opulence and grandeur of the 18th century. I also absolutely adored the costumes used as well. The musical score is also fantastic. It's a crucial element and really just adds a certain gravitas to this wonderful film. It's a beautiful and evocative soundtrack, which features a combination of songs Farinelli would have sung back in the day and some new interpreted performances. As I mentioned earlier, the acting performances here, particularly from Stefano Dionisi as Farinelli, are phenomenal. Dionisi portrays the castrato in a captivating and emotionally resonant way. A lot of the acting he's done with his eyes, and even though he's miming the singing bits, he makes it so believable and he's absolutely fascinating and captivating, and you cannot take your eyes off of him. Look, is this a perfect film? By no means, but in the same breath though, I found it very captivating, engrossing, beautifully touching, and very well made. From its enlightening performances, beautiful costume design and cinematography, and superbly emotional musical soundtrack that left me awe-inspired. Albeit cruel and barbaric to have castrated a young boy to basically steal away his manhood, as it were, the one good that came from this was that the phenomenal voice of Farinelli could be heard by so many. Unfortunately, we will never quite know exactly how he truly sounded, but I do believe that this film, in some ways, captures that most beautiful, powerful, and emotional resonance that music can only bring. Farinelli gets a 9.5 out of 10.